Hello everyone, welcome you all again to the Sanal Technology Tutorial. Today in this video I am going to show you from your syllabus, that is another topic. The topic is here sorting algorithm. So here see, from the unit 2 we have discussed almost all the things. So that is this one, the sorting algorithm is there. So in this sorting algorithm we have to discuss now bubble sort and insertion sort. Okay, so count the number of operations while sorting. So this topic we have to discuss now. For this topic I have prepared one PPT and two programs, that is bubble sort and insertion sort, for you. So I'm going to show you how to implement the program, how to execute the program. Okay, now see here, this is the sorting algorithm program I have prepared for you. So this PPT, okay, here see, sorting algorithm means, sorting means already you know that either ascending or descending entered elements into a list or into an array or anywhere. That means if any elements are there in the array in this order, so you have to arrange the order. So you can arrange by either ascending or descending order. So how can you arrange the elements? How can you sort the elements? For that some algorithms are there. So in your syllabus only two algorithms are there, that is bubble sort and insertion sort. So about that we are going to discuss now. So now see about bubble sort. What about the bubble sort? See, bubble sort is the simplest sorting algorithm that works by repeatedly swapping the adjacent element if there are in wrong order. Okay, now see, in this PPT 51428, first suppose you have entered these values, okay, 51428. Now you have to arrange, that means from suppose ascending order, 1 2 4 5 8, it has to come, right? So now for the first time, what it will do, for the first time it will check the first two elements. That means already it was there, that means it will in the previous line, that it will compare the elements with the adjacent. That means this element will compare with this one, right? So now see here, this is 5, will compare with 1. 1 is the smallest one, so what it will do, it will go to the this place of 5 and 5 will go to here, that is swapping. So it will swap the elements 5 and 1, okay, and rest of all will remain same. Okay, so this is the way. So now here see, so it will compare with 5 and 1. So 1 is the smaller one, so 1 will come first, then 5 will come. So here see 1 and 5, then remaining elements will same, that is 4 2 8. So 1 5 4 2 8, done. After that here the algorithm compares the first two elements and sweeps since 5 greater than 1. So how many time it will compare? See, first time it has compared these two elements. After that, for the next time, what it will do? 1 and 5 already compared. Now again it will go to the next place. That means it will compare with 5 and 4. Okay, so that is 5 and 4. So 4 is the smallest one, smaller one. So 5 will, 4 will come here and 5 will go into the 4th place. So that is swap. So 1 is there, 4 and 5 is swapped, and remaining elements will same, 2 and 4. So why it is swapped? Since 5 greater than 4, that is why it is swapped. Okay, so after that see again, it will go to the next position. First it will check, the first two comparison, then second two comparison, then third two comparison, then fourth comparison, like that it will swap. So here see, for a third time 1 and 4 will remain same, then it will compare 5 and 2 again. So this time after sweeping this line, you are getting this line. Okay, this line you got here. So here in this line it will compare the third and fourth element. So fourth is the smaller one, so fourth will come here and 5 will go there. So here see, 1 4 2 5 8 1 4 2 1 4 5 2 8 1 4 2 5 8, you got swept. After that see, 1 4 2 5 8, already this is swept, already it is in ascending order. So what to do? No need to swap again. So here the same values you will get, 1 4 2 5 8. That means 5 and 8 will compare. So here 5 is already smaller than 8, that is why no need to swap. That is why it is coming 1 4 2 5 8. Now since these elements are already in order 8 greater than 5, algorithm does not swap them. Done. So this is the first pass. So how many elements are there in the list, that much of time it will swap. In the second pass, what it will come? See, here how many elements? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many passes will be there? Third passes will be there, because in the algorithm you have to use n minus 1 minus 1. So how it will do in the program you will get. In the second time, what you will get, see, this result you got for the first pass, that means 1, 4, 2, 5, 8. Is it in ascending order? No, because 2, see, 2 has to come here, right? So now here, see, for the second time, it will again the same procedure it will follow. 1 and 4 it will compare first. So 1 and 4 is already in order, so no sweeping is there. 1, 4, 2, 5, 8, the same line you are getting here. So for 1, 4, 2, 5, 8, again it will compare the second two positions, that is 4 and 2 will compare. So 2 is the smaller one, so 2 and 4 will sweep. So that is why 1, 2, 4, 5, 8 is coming, swept, right? After that, again the third positions and fourth position will check. So compare. So 1, 2, 4 and 5. 4 and 5 will compare, remain, it is in order, so it is coming the same line. Again, it will compare the second, next lines, next two values, that means 5 and 8. So 5 is smaller than 8, so no sweeping is there. So after sweeping this line, you are getting the values 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Okay, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8 you got. That means in order, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. It is already in the ascending order. So here, after that, 3 times you have to sweep. So here in the third pass, what you will get? Now see, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, already it is swept, already it is in order, so it is coming 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Again, two values, then second two values will compare, same values will come, no sweeping is there. Again, third and fourth, again fourth and fifth. After that, after the sorting, you are getting the values 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Okay? So how many values were there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values were there. So for 5 values, we have compared how many times? 1, 2, 3. That means 3 passes you have done. If there 10 values are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, suppose 9, 10 values are there in the array or in the list. So then, how many times it will compare? It will compare 8 times. N minus 1 minus 1. Just remember that. Okay? Now go to the next one. Here see, again showing the same example. So here the 5, 3, 1, 9, 8, 2, 4, 7, 4, 7, these values are there in the list or array. In this list, 5 is, it is showing programmatically, see I value for the first pass, okay? So here in the previous one, see, this is for the first pass, this is for the second pass, and this is for the third pass. Already you know about looping, right? So the same task when it will repeat again and again, this is known as loop, already you know. So this is one loop. What it is doing here, and the same thing it is doing here also, and the same thing it is doing here also. That means same task it is repeating. That means this is a loop. 1, 2, 3 times it is doing. That is a loop. Okay. For this looping, we are using I. And here, inside this loop, see, again it is comparing, again it is comparing, again it is comparing, again it is comparing. So another looping is there inside this loop. Yes or not? This is one loop. First pass, second pass, third pass. This is one loop. And inside first pass, see, it is comparing 5 and 1. It is comparing 5 and 4. It is comparing 5 and 2. It is comparing 5 and 8. So what is the meaning of this? That means that 5, it is comparing with both all the elements. That means what? That is one also looping. So for this loop, we are taking here J. Okay? So now see, in the next example, here see, I for the first pass, I, this is first pass, this is second pass, this is third pass, this is fourth pass, like that it is going. So here see, how many elements are there? 5, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 elements are there, right? So how many comparisons you will get? You will get 6 comparison. Already I told, n minus 1 minus I. So that is why I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 comparison you are getting. Finally, you are getting the result here. So it is starting from 0. That is why it is 6 comparison means 7 comparisons you are getting here. So here see, 5 and 3 first you have to compare, right? So this is for J. This comparison, what you are doing inside this, that means this part, this is J. And this is I. This is I. So I is starting with 0, 1, 1 2 3 4 5 6, okay, and here j is starting with 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. Here see how many six comparisons are there. I means how many elements are there. 8 elements are there. So here see 5 and 3 it is comparing, okay, 5 and first two positions it is comparing. 5 I value is j value is what here, 0. J value is what here, 1 2 3. These values are of j. J's values are 1 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. That means these positions we are taking, these elements are there in the index or in the position 0. This is in 1, this is in 2, this is in 3, like that. This is storing the elements. 5 is there in 0, 3 is there in 1. That means J 0, 5, J 1, 3, like that. Okay. So now for first comparison, see 5 and 3 you are comparing. 3 is the smallest one. So 3 will come here and 5 will place here. Then remaining all are same. 1, 9, 8, 2, 4, 7. Done. Now J's value again it will increase. Now the value of this is loop, that is why it will increase again and again, right? So J value is now, this is 1. Now it will compare this 3 and 1. So this time when it will compare 3 and 1, 3 is the smallest one, 1 is the smallest one. So 1 will come here in the next line here, 1 will come here and 5 will place here. Then remaining all are same, see. Then J value again increase, that is what J value is this time, 2. J value is 2 now. This is J value is 2 now. In 2, J value is 2 now. 2 means here. So it is comparing in the third time these values, 5 and 9. So 5 and 9 is already sorted. So no swapping is there. 5, 9, 8, 2, 4, 7. Done. Okay. Then next time J value is 3. So 8. J value is 3 means 8. This 3 is there, J value is 3, this is 8. So 8 and 9 it will compare. So already swept, oh no, 8 and 9, it is swept here. Then 8, 9, 2, 4, 7 it has placed. Then again, like that it will increase 5, 6, 7, okay. So after once this J loop will finish, then again what we'll do, because I is also there in loop. So I will again increase, now the value of I is 1. After sorting these elements, you are getting the values 3, 1, 5, 8, 2, 4, 9, 7. It has not sorted. Okay. So what to do? Again, it will compare from the first position with the second one, second position with the third one, like that. So the first position value is 3 and 1. So it will compare 3 and 1. So 1 will place here, 3 will go there. Again, it will compare 3 and 5. So this is in order. So no swapping is there. Then again, 5 and 8. So no swapping, the same lines are there. Then again 8 and 2. So 8 and 2 means it has to sweep. So that is why 2 is coming here, 8 is going there. See, 4 and 7. Now this time, after this 4 and 8 you have to compare. This is already swept. 4 and 8, it is comparing. It is swept, 4 is coming and 8 is going there. And after that, the values, after sweeping all this thing, you got the result 1, 3, 5, 2, 4, 8, 7. Again, this I will increase. So like that, it will go again and again. So you will see in programmatically when it will execute the code, so you will understand everything clearly. And one another sorting is there, that is insertion sort. In this insertion sort, see, insertion sort is the sorting mechanism where the sorted array is built having one item at a time. The array elements are compared with each other sequentially and then arranged simultaneously in some particular order. So here see, this is the insertion sort. So what it will do? In insertion sort, the technique is, this array is there, 17, 25, 31, 13 and 2. So these elements you have to sort. So it will compare the first two elements, 25 and 17. So 17 is the smaller one, so 17 will come here, 25 will place here. Okay, so done. And the next time what it will do, it will compare, see the 25, so 25 and 31 it will compare. So here it is comparing 31 is greater than 25, so 31 is greater than 25, so no swapping is there, 31 is already greatest one, no swapping is there. Then again 31 compare with 17, no swapping is there, 31 is compared with 25 and 31 is again compared with 17. No swapping is there. Done. So after this, 31 is already compared. Now go to the next one. So again, this time you have to compare 17 and 25 you have compared. Now you have to compare 13. So 13 you are comparing with 31. 13 you are comparing with 31. Okay. This is no swapping is there. Then again, 13 you are comparing with 25. That means this 13 you are comparing with 31 also. This 13 you are comparing with 25 also. So 13 is comparing is 31. So no swapping is there. 13 is comparing with 13 is comparing is 25. That is all. There is also. Yes, 13 is comparing with 25. So 13 is less than 25. So 13 will come here. Okay, 25 will go there. So see, 13 and 25. Done. So after that, again, 13 you have to compare with 17 also. That means 13 you are comparing with 31 also. 13 you are comparing with 25 also. 13 you are comparing with 17 also. Done. So 17 is the smaller one. So 13 will go first. After that, 17 will come. So this is the steps. This is the swapping. So you try to understand from here. And I'm going to show you the program, how it will exactly execute, okay? So that you will understand clearly. So now see, directly I'm going to show you the program. This is the bubble sort technique. This is the bubble sort program. I'll send you this program in mail. So here, see, program to sort a list using bubble sort. So in this list, BB is the list here. The list values are these, 5, 6, 1, 8, 9. These values are there in BB, okay? Try to understand clearly. Print original list is BB. So I am going to display the value of BB. It will come what? This list. 5, 6, 1, 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10 will come. Done. Then we are calculating for processing the length of the list. Okay. We are calculating the length of the list for processing. The length of the list is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The length of this BB is 9. Okay, 9 values are there. 9. Okay, then I am going to open notepad. So LE was what? LE is what? 9. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 values are there. The length of the list is 9. This is 9. Done. Now, see, we are taking one loop. As we have discussed in the algorithm, sorting algorithm. So like this we are going to do here. I is for the first loop and J is for the second loop. Already we have discussed before. Okay. So now in I, how many times this loop will execute? I loop will execute. The value of the I loop will execute C in range LE. LE means the value of LE is what? 9. So how many times this loop will execute? This loop will execute 9 times. The value of I is for the first time, that is the value of I is 0. Then second time it is 1. Then it will 2, 3, 4. Up to where it will go? It will go up to 8. Because LE is the value there. The value of LE is 9. So already you know if you are giving the range here 10, that means it will go to 9. In loop already we have discussed. So here LE value is 9 here. That means it will go up to 8. Clear? That means I value you will get from 0 to 8. It is clear? Okay. So now see. Again inside this loop, the value of I is now 0 for the first time. Okay. I is now 0. After that, the range is I range is, this is 0 to 8. This is range. This is range. And for the first time, the value of I is 0. Okay. Now, J is equal to for J in range, this is another loop. In this loop, what we are doing? This loop will start from 0. This loop will start from 0 and end with where it will end. See, J value, it will start from J is equal to start from 0 and end with where it will end. It will end here. See, LE means 9, minus 1 means 8, minus 1 means 7. That means 0 to 7. 0 to 7 not actually. So here it is, the value is 7. 9 minus 1 minus 1. 7. 7. If it is 7, that means it will go to 6. Clear? So that means this range is, J range is here, okay, J is equal to, range is 0 to, range is 0 to where? 7, oh no, okay, range is 0 to 6, J range is 0 to 6, this is range, and the value of J is here, this is 0, for the first time, okay. So now you are getting the value of I is 0 here and the value of J is also 0 here. Okay, how many times this J loop will execute? This J loop will execute 0 to 6. I loop will execute 0 to 8. Clear? So now come to the next part. See, both condition is true because both are 0, I and J. This loop is true, so you are here inside this loop. Once this loop will finish, up to here actually, once this loop will finish, then again this loop will increase the value of I. Clear? So now inside J, the value of J is 0 now. This condition is true. Come inside. If condition is there, BBJ. Now try to understand what is the value of BBJ. BBJ. Now tell me what is the value of BBJ. BB is our list. BB is this list. Okay? This list, this is in 0 position. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. These values are stored. BBJ means BB0, J value is 0 here, BB0. So what is the value of BB0? Can you tell me? BB0 value is here 5. Okay, so here this is 5. Now what you are doing? Greater than BBJ plus 1. BB0 plus 1 means 1. So here it is giving greater than BB, here 0 plus 1. BB 0 plus 1. BB 0 plus 1 means 1. So what is the value of BB 0 plus 1? BB 1. The value of BB 1, see, BB 0 1 is 6 here. BB 1 is 6 here. So now you are comparing 5 and 6. 5 is less than 6. Condition is true or false? If 5 greater than 6, condition is false. Right? So it is already smaller than 6. So this condition is false. If it is false, then what happened? If it is false, that means it will not come inside this line. That means this line will not execute. Why? Because already 5 is smaller than 6. Done? So this is finished. This condition is finished. After finish this condition, where you have to go? Not to this print line. Why? Because this is loop. Now again, the value of I, J will increase. The value of J will increase. Can you tell me what is the value of J now? This time no swapping was there. That means here the value you got what? 5 and 6 in the list. Okay, no need to write this. Just see. Here the value of J will increase now. What is the value of J is now? The value of J is here. This is 1. Because it is loop, that is why it is increased. The value of J is 1 now. So this is not 0 now. This is 1. If it is 1, BBJ means BB1. What is the value of BB1? The value of BB1 is 6. Okay. So, okay. For the first line, what you got? We got here 5. There was no swapping. 5, 6, 1, 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10. These values was there. Okay. After one value comparison. Now the value of J is 1. So if it is 1 this time, so what to compare? BBJ means BB1. What is the value of BB1? 0, 1. The BB1 is 6 here. Clear? So BB1 is 6 here. So here this value is 6. And BB, here what to write? J plus 1 means 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1. So BB value J is 1 already. BBJ value is 1 already. 1 plus 1 means BB1 plus 1. So BB1 plus 1 value is BB2. BB2 is what? 0, 1, 2. BB2 is 1 here. So here the value is 1. Done? This 1, BB2. So now you are comparing 6 with 1. So 6 is greater than 1. That means this condition is true this time. Right? 6 is greater than 1. This condition is true. If this condition is true, then you have to come inside. So come inside means this line will execute now. In this line, what you will get? You will get BBJ means BB1 value is BBJ plus 1. And BBJ plus 1 value is BBJ. That means it is swapped. okay. So BBJ means BB1 is now here. See, 5 is already there. We are comparing BB1 and BB1 plus 1. So BBJ means BB1. To BB1, we are assigning BB1 plus 1, BB2. That means sweeping. That means this 1 will come here. 1. And BBJ plus 1 means this position. BBJ plus 1, BB2 is BBJ, means BB1. That means this 6 you have to write here. 6 will come here. And remaining all will same. 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10. After that, again what it will do? Again see, the value of J will increase this time again. The value of J, we have done 1. Now the value of J is 2. Okay, this is 2 now. So when it is 2, so BB, this is BB2 we are comparing. That is BBJ greater than BBJ plus 1. That is BB2 greater than BB2 plus 1 means 3. BB2 plus 1. Meaning BB3. So what is the value of BB2 and 3? Just you have to see. So after comparison this one, you are getting this line. So here, BB2 is what? See, 0, 1, 2. BB2 is 6 here. Okay, this is 6 here. BB3 is 8 here. So you are getting the value here is 8. So now you are comparing 6 and 8. So here what you are getting? This comparison condition is greater than 8. That means this is false. No sweeping is there. Okay, no sweeping is there. False. So again what happened? Again the value, that means this line will not execute. That means no sweeping has done. So again the value of J will increase. Now the value of J is what? 3. After 2 this is 3. So we have to compare. Oh, no sweeping is there means here we have to, we will get the line 5, 1, 6, 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10. Okay, now you are getting the value of J is 3. So BB 3 and BB 3 plus 1 you are getting here. 3 plus 1 means 4. So now here see, BB 3 value is what? 0, 1, 2, 3. BB 3 value is 8 here this time. This is 8. And BB 4 value is what? BB 4 value is 9. 9. Now see, 8 greater than 9 according to this condition. Condition is false. Condition is false. If it is false, that means this will not execute. This line will not execute. No sweeping is there. That means same line you will get again. So you have to write here 5, 1, 6, 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10. Done. Now the value of J you will get here. This is 4. So BB4 is there and BB4 plus 1. That is 5 here. So what is the value of BB4? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. BB4 is 9 here. So this is 9. And BB5 is 2 here. So you are comparing 9 and 2. Okay, this comparison is true, true, because 9 greater than 2, condition is true. If this condition is true, then what happened? This has to execute this line. That means this sweeping has to do. So BBJ means BB4 value, it will go to the BB5, and BB5 value, it will come to the BB4. Okay, so now this sweeping has to do, 4 and 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This 2 will come here, 9 will go there. Okay, so now here, 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 9, 2, 9, 4, 3, 10. Done. After this, you have to compare with 5. This is J value is 5 now. It is increased. This is loop. That's why it is increasing. This is 5 and this is 5 plus 1, 6. Alright, 5 plus 1 already we have done or what? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, we have not done. This is 5 plus 1. BB5 value is 9 here. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. BB5 value is 9 here. Okay. So this 9 we have to compare with BB5 plus 1. This is 4. 9 and 4 you are comparing. So this is greater than 4. 9 greater than 4. 9 greater than 4. This condition is true. That means again this sweeping has to do. And 4 will come here, 9 will go there. Okay. So in this line you have to write 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 4, 9, 3, 10. Done. So this time again the value of J is, this is 6. So here this is BB6 and this is BB6 plus 1. BB6 plus 1. Now the value of BB6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. BB6 is what here? 9. BB6 is 9 here. So BB6 value is 9 here. And BB7 value, 6 plus 1, means the 7 value is 3 here. So this is 3 here. Now you are comparing with 9 and 3. This condition is also true. That means this swapping has to do. So this swapping has to do means you have to write here the line 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, then 10 will there. So after pass one value, for the, after the first pass, you will get the result 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, 10 according to the sorting algorithm what we have discussed in the PPT. Okay, then what you do, you are getting this line after after comparing each elements in the list, after comparing each elements in the list, you are getting this line. Okay, this line means the last line here, this one 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, 10. Now the value of BB, this BB is this, not this one, what is there in the original list. Okay, after execution one time, the value of I is 0 now. In one time, when you are comparing all the elements here in Z, so you are getting this line. Okay, after that what you will do, see this comparison has finished because J will go to 0 to 6 only. Okay, this loop is finished. This J loop is finished now, 0 to 6 already done. So this line is finished, this loop is finished. After finish this line, what you will get? This printf line is there. Printf, print after pass I element BB. So this line will print. So what it will print in this line? It will print in this line like C. It will display after pass I element. What is the value of I here? Can you tell me? The value of I is 0 here. After pass 0, then again it will write ELEMENT element. After pass 0 element, then again colon will come, then BB will come, the value of BB, this BB. So the value of BB after pass 0 element, you will get this line, this line you will get. Okay, this line, control C, control B. So after pass 0 element, this line you will get. After that what it will do? After that again see, this line is finished. Where is this line? This line is inside this loop. So again this is a loop. So again this thing will execute, repeat, it will again, it will repeat these lines. Why? Because the value of I will increase now. Now the value of I is 1. Okay, so I was 0 here. So this is the value of I is now this time 1. Clear? So I will go to 0 to 8 it will go. Now this is 1. Now again this thing will happen. Now the value of J will again start from 0 to where? You have to see. Now here again the value of 0 to 6, the same comparisons will be there. Now again the value of J you will get, see 0 to 6, this is 0 to 6, and for the first time the value of J is 0, so here the value of 0 again. So again BB0, so BB0 and BB0 plus 1. BB0 plus 1. So when it will compare this, then it will compare these lines now. That means BB0 means this 5, BB1 means this line, this one. Like that, the similarly what you have done in the first comparisons, and here also you will get the second comparison. So when you will compare these values, so what you will get? Can you tell me? You will get here, see 5 and 1 you will compare, so you will get 1, 5, then again 6, 8, 2, 4, remaining all are same, okay, 3, 9, 10, done. Then again you are going to compare, the value of J will increase, the value of J is 1 now, so again you are going to compare. So here you will get 1 you have to place, then you have to write 5 and 6 you are going to compare. So 5 and 6 compare, no swapping is there because 5 is less than 6. So here again 5, 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, 10, then again the value of J will increase. 5 and 6 already compared, now you have to compare with 6 and 8. So where here you have to write 1, 5, 6 and 8, that means it is already sorted order, so no need to sweep. 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, 10, 6 and 8 already compared. Now you have to compare this 8 and 2, so here 2 is smaller than 8, so it will sweep. So here you will get the values 1, 5, 6, 2, 8, 8, then 4, 3, 9 and 10. Then 8 and 2 already we have compared. Now you have to compare 2 and 8. Okay. 8 and 2 already compared. Now this 8 and 4 you have to compare. So you will get the values here 1, 5, 6, 2, 4, 8, 3, 9, 10. Then the next line you will get again 1, 5, 6, 2, 4, 3, 8, 9, 10. Okay, done. Now again you will get the values here 1, 5, 6, 2, 4, 3, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Then again 9, 10 you have to compare. So you will get the value ultimately 1, 5, 6, 2, 4, 3, 8, 9 after pass the second element. So it will display the line again, this one. This line it will print again. That means J value has finished up to 6. Then again what it will do? Again the value of I will increase. Like that it will repeat again and again. So after getting the value of I is 8 according to the range. I is range 8. That means this loop is also finished. When this loop will finish, then it will go to this line. Print after sorting, it will display this BB. That means after sorting, the BB values it will display. The sorted array you will get. So now you can see here. So suppose I am copying this line. Enter, Control V. So here, after doing the second execution, the value of I is 1 now. So here you will get, after pass, in place of I, here you are writing, see, I is writing here. So that is in place of I, you are getting the value 1, after pass 1 element. So before that you got here after pass 0 element. So here you are getting after pass 1 element. So what you will get? 5, 1, 6, not 5, 1, 6. This line you will get here. After pass 1 element, you will get this line. Mm-hmm. Now see, I am going to run this program. Okay, F5. This is the original list, what is there in the BB, see, 5, 6, 1, 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10, 5, 6, 1, 8, 9, 2, 4, 3, 10, done. After pass 0 element, after pass 0 element, you are getting the values 5, 1, 6, 8, okay, what we got here, see, 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, 10, here see, 5, 1, 6, 8, 2, 4, 3, 9, 10, right, after pass, after that what you got, after pass 1 element, 1562, see 1562, 43, 8, 9, 10, 1562, 43, 8, 9, 10, done. So like that you will get the values after sorting all the elements. That means after, when you will get the value of I is 8, that means your loop will finish. So like that you will get the part, this is one part, this is second part, this is third part, this is fourth part, you will get up to 8. Then you will get the result, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. That means the list is already sorted. Done. So this is about the bubble sort. Already we have done. Okay. Now we are going to the next one. That is insertion sort. This one. So I'll suggest you that you just practice this bubble sort one day. And insertion sort is another day. Because you will get confused when you will going to do both the comparisons at the same day. Okay. So now I'm going to show you about the insertion sort here. This is the insertion sort program. Okay. In this insertion sort program, see, delete all this. So here I'm going to write the values. A value is, these are the values. 15, 6, 32, these are the values of A of this list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 values are there. Okay. Original list it will print for the, again this loop is taking here, I in range will start from 1, that means I value will start from 1 to where it will go to, it will go to len A. Len A means the value of this length of this list 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, that means the value here is 7, that means it will go up to 6 1 2 6. Clear? Now here inside this loop what you are doing, see, key is one variable you are taking here. To key you are assigning a value, that is AI. What is the value of AI? Can you tell me? The value of key you are getting here, what? AI means A, what is the value of I? I value is not 0 here, I value is 1 here. Why? Because it is already given the value. I value will start from 1. See, I value will start from 1 to 6. So, A1, what is the value of A1? The value of A1 is 15 here. The key value is 15 here. Clear? Then again, so how I am doing in Notepad? So, when you are going to practice any of the program, so you can write in rough paper like this. Okay? So that it is easy to understand. So after that, see, j is equal to I minus 1, it is written here. So in the next line, the value of j you are getting here, see, j is equal to I minus 1. The value of I is what? 1. 1 minus 1 means 0. The value of j is 0 now. Clear? So again, one another loop you are getting here, while loop. That means this task will repeat again and again until the condition is satisfied. So here, see, while j greater than equal to 0, that means the value of j is what? The value of j is 0 here. J greater than equal to 0, 0 greater than equal to 0, this condition is true or false? This is true because is equal is also there. 0 greater than equal to 0, condition is true. And that means both conditions should be true if you are getting AND operation, logical AND operation. That means this condition and this condition should be true, then only this will execute. If this is true, this is false, that means it will not execute. Why? This is AND. If you are getting OR here, then only if any of the condition is true, that means the entire condition is true. Now here it is AND, so both conditions should be true. Okay, this first condition is already true, that is 0 greater than equal to 0, this is true. Now come to this part, key less than AJ, what is the value of key here? The value of key is 15 here. And what is the value of key of AJ here? What is the value of AJ here? AJ, can you tell me the value of AJ? J means what is the value of J? J value is 0 here. AJ, what is the value of AJ? The value of AJ is, okay, in the first one that was wrong, because see, key is equal to AI, AI means A1 here, okay, A1, the value of I is starting from 1, A1, so A1 means 0, 1, that means 6, the value of key is not 15, this is 6, clear? Now here, AJ, J value is 0 here, J value is 0 here. AJ. So AJ value is what? AJ A0. A0 value is 15. So here you are getting the value as 15. Now you are comparing key and AJ. Key and AJ. The value of key is here. This is 6 and this is 15. 6 less than 15. Condition is true. Right? This condition is also true and this condition is also true. That means entire condition is true. So now you have to come inside. So here what you will get? AJ plus 1 means AJ plus 1 means J value is 0, A 0 plus 1, A 0 plus 1 means 1, A1, okay, A1 is equal to what you are writing, A1 is equal to AJ means A 0, what is the value of A 0, A 0 value is 15 now, okay, A 0 value is 15 now, so A1 you are assigning, AJ plus 1 you are assigning 15, clear, so this is A 0, this is A0. A0 is 15, was there 15. Now A0 plus 1, A1 is 15. You are assigning the value of AJ. A0 you are assigning to AJ plus 1. Then J value has changed. Now the value of J is J minus 1. The value of J was 0. 0 minus 1. That means minus 1. Now the value of J is J minus 1 means minus 1. J is equal to minus 1 now. Done. Okay. That means after checking the one condition, we have changed the value of this this one. That means A0. AJ plus 1's value we have changed. AJ plus 1's means A0 plus 1. A1's value we are assigning AJ. This A0. That means A1's value you got here 15. Here is 15 now. In place of 6, this is 15 now after execution of this line. Okay. So now see what it will do. Again, this is a loop. Since this condition is true, so it will not go to the else part. Okay. Again, it will go here. The value of I will increase. Now the value of I is what? The value of I is 2 this time. Okay. So now what it will do? Here, key is equal to AI. The value of key is equal to AI. A, I means what? This is 2. A2. What is the value of A2 now? 0, 1, 2, this is 13. Okay, this is 13. So now it will the value of key is now this time this is 13. Now again j is equal to I minus 1. So j is equal to I minus 1 means this, when this loop will finish, then only it will go here. This loop j is equal to what you got? You got the value of j is minus 1. Okay, if it is minus 1, again this loop will execute. So here j value is minus 1 here, greater than equal to 0, then only this will execute. This is false, minus 1. This is minus 1, this is 0. This condition is false, means this entire condition is false. Now you have to go here. Now the value of I is, this is 2. I is 1, I was 1, now it is 2. It is increased. Key is equal to A2. The value of A2 is 0, 1, 2. A2 is 13 here. So key value you are getting here, 13. Clear? Now, again J is equal to I minus 1. The value of J is equal to I minus 1. What is the value of I? The value of I is 2 now. 2 minus 1 means 1. The value of J is 1 now. 1. Again, here it will do what? It will compare these values. See, J means 1 greater than equal to 0. This condition is true. So here, key. What is the value of key is there? 13. Less than AJ means A. J means 1. What is the value of A1? A1 is, what is here? This is not 6 now, this is 15 now, right? We have already done in the previous one, previous comparison, that we have swept these values. 15 is there now, okay? So now you are comparing, these values are 15 and 13. This is key is 13 and this is 15. This is less than this. This condition is true. So again it will come inside. So again it will swap. So like that, actually this swapping will happen. So try to understand once by yourself, then only you will understand the program. Otherwise, how many times I will say, your concept will not clear. Okay, first, how we have compared the first two values and according to the algorithm what we have done, try to understand by yourself, then you will understand automatically everything. But you have to think, you have to try, then only you will understand. Okay, try to understand. If any doubt you will find again, you can call me or you can send me in WhatsApp. Okay, thank you. Bye bye. That means we have already finished this sorting algorithm also. So we will go to next topic in the next video. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.